In November 1969, Apollo 12 blasted off from Earth on a mission to land two astronauts on the moon. But what happened to the rocket's third stage after it completed its task of propelling the spacecraft towards the moon, the vast expanse of space? Did it crash into a planet? Was it captured by a passing asteroid? Did it keep circling around the sun, all by itself as a reminder of one of the greatest things humans have ever accomplished? The answers to these questions have remained shrouded in mystery until now. Join us as we embark on a journey through space and time, following the 30-year odyssey of Apollo 12's third stage. Along the way, we'll explore the science of space exploration, uncover the secrets of the solar system, and perhaps even discover the fate of this enigmatic object. But before we dive into the video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel to join our community of space enthusiasts. Now let's begin. In September of 2002, astronauts made a shocking discovery. They spotted an asteroid in an unusual orbit around Earth. Now, you might be thinking, what's so unusual about that? Well, as far as they knew, the only natural object that orbited our planet was the moon. So this strange object couldn't be an asteroid. It had to be something that we made. As it turns out, this mysterious object was none other than the Saturn V third stage rocket that launched the Apollo 12 astronauts to the moon back in 1969. Yes, you read that right. This rocket had been on a wild, unknown journey through space for 30 years before finally making a comeback around Earth. But the question is, what the heck happened to this rocket? And how did it end up on such a bizarre journey? Well, that's exactly what we're going to explore in this video. It all started with a tiny error in the Apollo 12 mission that set the rocket stage on an unexpected 30-year trip through space. Let's break down the journey of the Saturn V rocket used in the Apollo 12 mission. This rocket was a true feat of engineering, consisting of three stages. The first stage would burn for a short 2.5 minutes, propelling the rocket to an altitude of 61 kilometers. Then, the second stage would take over and burn for about 6 minutes, pushing the rocket higher and faster. Finally, the third and final stage would ignite, putting the spacecraft into orbit. Once in orbit, the third stage would fire again to perform the translunar injection burn, which sent the rocket and the crew on a trajectory towards the moon. After the crew had safely launched towards the moon, the third stage would separate and NASA would attempt to discard it. However, things didn't go as planned for Apollo 12. Instead of reaching the desired solar orbit, the third stage was slingshotted around the moon and onto an unknown journey. It's bizarre to think that this rocket, designed and built by humans, ended up drifting through space for 30 years. So what happened to Apollo 12 third stage? When NASA sent the Apollo 12 mission to the moon, they had to get rid of the rocket's third stage after it had done its job. NASA set the third stage on a path towards the moon, but it was heading towards the wrong side of the moon. To fix this, they needed to change the path of the third stage by slowing it down just a little bit. However, NASA didn't realize that the tracking system they were using to monitor the rocket's speed was not completely accurate. They thought the rocket was going faster than it really was, so they slowed it down too much. This caused the third stage to miss its target and end up in a strange orbit around the Earth that kept changing. The third stage, known as the S-IVB stage, was equipped with two sets of auxiliary propulsion systems, which consisted of thrusters located at the bottom of the stage. The thrusters were responsible for controlling the rotation of the spacecraft or rocket stage, which are referred to as yaw, pitch, and roll. Yaw refers to the left and right rotation of the spacecraft around its vertical axis. Pitch refers to the up and down rotation of the spacecraft around its lateral axis. Roll refers to the rotation of the spacecraft around its longitudinal axis. The S-IVB stage had to change its position by thousands of kilometers, but it took very little energy to do so, because changing its trajectory so early in the journey would have a big effect once it reached the moon. At the time of separation, the third stage was traveling at around 20,000 kilometers an hour. In order to change its trajectory, it had to slow down by about 140 kilometers an hour, which would delay its approach to the moon and make it arrive at the opposite side. However, unknown to NASA at the time, the tracking system used to monitor the S-IVB stage was off by a tiny amount. The instrument unit located above the S-IVB stage had its own internal guidance unit on board, which was used to plot the rocket's trajectory. It also had two C-band transponders that would send signals back to ground stations on Earth, giving NASA more accurate trajectory data. Once the rocket was safely in orbit, NASA could compare this data with the rocket's own data and see if it was following the desired flight path. If anything was off, they could send a command up to the rocket to correct it. They overcorrected by just 40 kilometers an hour, but this was enough to drastically delay its arrival to the moon, causing it to miss by thousands of kilometers. Instead of being thrown out into a solar orbit, the S-IVB stage ended up in a highly elliptical orbit around the Earth. Over the next 15 months, the orbit was constantly stretched and pulled in different directions by the Earth and Moon's gravity. It got stretched all the way out to Lagrange Point 1. Lagrange Point 1 is a point in space between the Earth and the Sun where the gravitational forces of both bodies cancel out. This point is also known as the L1 point. Once the Apollo 12 third stage passed beyond this point, it started to be influenced more by the Sun's gravity. To understand this, you can imagine a car trying to climb a steep hill. If the car does not have enough velocity to reach the top of the hill will drag it back down to the bottom. However, if the car has enough velocity to move past the top, it will start to get pulled down by the other side. This is exactly what happened to the third stage. It passed the L1 hill and was now being dragged into an orbit around the Sun. Even though the third stage achieved what it was meant to achieve, its orbit around the Sun was far from stable. Instead of being accelerated to a solar orbit on the outside of Earth, it had been slowed down into an orbit on the inside of Earth. As a result, the third stage was now completing its lap around the Sun a little bit quicker than the Earth. This meant it was slowly pulling away, but it was only a matter of time before the third stage would catch back up. In 1986, the third stage did catch up to the Earth, but it wasn't quite close enough to the L1 point to get pulled back into Earth's orbit. The third stage carried on racing around the Sun for another 16 years before the inevitable finally happened. In 2002, the third stage reached its highest point in orbit, called apoapsis, just as the Earth came close enough to pull it into its orbit. The third stage finally re-entered the Earth's atmosphere and burned up. So, how did astronomers identify this object in space? Astronomers use various methods to identify objects in space, such as telescopes, cameras, and spectroscopy. Telescopes help to observe the objects in space and to detect their position, size, and shape. Cameras are used to capture images of the objects, which can then be analyzed to determine their properties. Spectroscopy is a technique that is used to identify the chemical composition of an object in space. It involves measuring the amount of light that is absorbed or emitted by the object at different wavelengths. Different elements and compounds absorb and emit light at specific wavelengths, creating a unique spectral fingerprint. By analyzing the spectral fingerprint of an object, astronomers can determine what elements and compounds it is made of. To use spectroscopy, astronomers collect light from the object using a telescope and direct it through a prism or a diffraction grating. This separates the light into its component wavelengths, creating a spectrum. The spectrum is then analyzed to identify the spectral lines, which correspond to the absorption or emission of specific elements or compounds. In the case of the Apollo 12 third stage, astronomers used spectroscopy to identify the object's composition. They took measurements of the light reflected by the object at different wavelengths and compared them to the spectra of known materials. They found that the spectrum of the object was very similar to that of white titanium oxide paint, which was used on the Saturn V rocket. This, combined with the trajectory analysis, allowed astronomers to confirm that the object was indeed the Apollo 12 third stage. Now you may be wondering, where is this object now? Is Saturn V third stage still in orbit or not? As of now, the Saturn V third stage is still in orbit around the Sun, and it will continue to orbit for many years to come. However, the laws of physics dictate that it will eventually be pulled back towards Earth and enter the atmosphere, where it will burn up upon re-entry. It is difficult to predict exactly when this will happen, as it depends on various factors such as the object's orbit, gravitational forces, and atmospheric conditions. However, astronomers have estimated that the Saturn V third stage will likely return to Earth's vicinity in the mid-2040s. Despite being a man-made object, the Saturn V third stage has become a part of the natural space environment and has been studied and tracked by astronomers for decades. Its journey through space offers valuable insights into the workings of our solar system and the laws of physics. The study of such objects can help us better understand the long-term behavior of objects in space and the impact of human activities on the space environment. So what is your favorite aspect of the Apollo 12 mission, and why? Share in the comments below. Also, like, subscribe, and if you enjoy our content, check this one out.